It was fall of 1871. Abilene. Phil Coe was from Texas and ran the Bull's Head Saloon and Gambling Den. He sold whiskey and men's souls inside. He was friendly enough to anyone who would pay him, but he was as vile of a character as I'd ever met. As three pretty ladies strolled in the Bull's Head, they asked for a Jack and Coke. So Mr. Phil gave them what they ordered, and I reckon even if I was there, I'd have wet my beak.
Where'd you get them with that?
And a cold one for Darla.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Darla and Tootin, y'all have a good one.
Abilene's one and only special deputy, Marshal Mike Williams, tried to get along with everyone.
Yes, sir.
Even Phil Coe. Never really had the best of ideas, but people listened to him because they said he had the best mustache in town.
A little slow. Yeah.
Why do you think that is?
The place, well, it's real nice, but it's a little dirty, you know?
A little dirty.
Yeah. I mean, look at this table. Yeah. It was spotless, but we live in the Wild West. It's dirty here.
Well, yeah. I mean, you have to expect stuff like that from bars. I mean, they can't be perfect. I mean, you do need to clean up a little bit, though.
I think it's beautiful. But, you know, maybe some advertising would help.
How about some decorations around your bar?
Decoration? Well, yeah. I have this horse, you see.
Horse? Well, you do have a good horse.
It says bar.
Yeah?
Well, we have that. What else would you say we should add?
I don't know, maybe some cow statues, you know, stuff like that. Stuff hanging up on the walls, you know.
Something to add the wow factor, maybe?
Yeah.
Really draw the crowds in, you know?
How about a picture or something?
Maybe of an animal.
Yeah.
A gamecock? No. A horse?
No.
Maybe a bull. A bull, yes.
Yeah. It should be on the side of your bar, I think.
Yes. A big picture. All over the wall. See it now. See it clearly.
Yeah. Well, I think that's a pretty good idea.
Darn tootin'.
Well, anyways, I gotta go. Good luck with your business around here.
Yes, sir. I thank you kindly.
All right.
Have a good one, Deputy.
Mike Williams only hoped to improve the saloon with this idea, but that Phil Coe had his own plan. He grabbed a paintbrush and got to work, making the most vile and disgusting picture ever to be seen in the town of Abilene. Just look at that thing. And Sheriff Wild Bill Hickok got involved.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
What can I do for you, Sheriff?
I need to talk to you about this thing you got up on the bar right here.
My advertising?
Yeah, well, you're going to have to take it down.
Sheriff, this is my property. I can do what I want with my property.
Sir, obviously the officer here, I need you to take it down by tomorrow or else.
It's my property. I do what I want.
You're going to regret it. You're
going to
regret this.
I promise you. Phil
didn't listen, and Wild Bill went with Mike to try and remove that abomination themselves from the side of the Bull's Head.
Can't let the town people see this.
What's wrong with it?
Just, I mean, look at it. I mean, well, come on.
You do got a good point again.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, imagine what would happen if Senor Reed saw this.
Oh, man, that wouldn't be a good
thing. Sorry, it was already bad enough. I just can't take it. I gotta... What do you think you're doing?
Hold my brush, man. I swear.
What am I doing? What are you doing? You can't just paint something like this on the side of a bar.
That is a disgrace.
Phil made a run for it, but he was no match for Wild Bill Hickok. Deputy Mike Williams tried his darndest to help out old Wild Bill, but he got caught in the wrong place at the wrong time and took one of Hickok's stray bullets straight to the face. Wild Bill's other bullet met his mark, however, and Phil Coe bit the dust. The end.
Go.
Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Nighttime would find me in Rose's Cantina. Music would play and
can't get the car door open.
All right, go.
What am I doing? What are you doing? This is a disgrace. It's a disgrace. You can't just paint something like this on the side of the bar. You know what the people are going to think about this? I'm about sick. You got to slap the crud out of me, son.
You gotta, I don't care if you slap me.
I'm like, just slap me.
Are you left-handed?
No, I don't know.
You were like.
With a little bit closer.
That's what I'm saying. You got to be like.
You got to red back me up.
Like. Yeah, like, wait, can I do a pimp slap?
Yeah,
like,
you gotta do something, cause that's right.
That was pathetic, Jackson.
I know.
Alright, let's practice one.
Okay. Wait, can I do a pimp slap or a regular slap?
We can try both, I guess. Just practice.
Oh, wait, no, I do both.
Uh-oh.
Which way are you gonna slap me? Which way do I need to fall? Right here in the grass? Or
wait, maybe I should fall so it doesn't look like I'm. I think I'm gonna hit you on that.
I feel like a slap is a little girly. I feel like it should be a punch.
Okay.
Alright, so be like that.
It would be so much easier if you were on this side because you couldn't see his hand like not touching your face and it would just be like this.
Like, I'm so scared I'm gonna hit you.
I don't even care if you hit me. It's not gonna hurt that bad. I mean, it's just.
Okay, well, if you get blood somewhere, I'll throw up on you. Straight up. Again. I have mustache in my nose. If y'all were wondering.
Okay, ready? No!
Pretend a kitten just died.
What just happened?
Kitten.
Alright, go for it. I didn't mean for you to walk away over there.
I said no, now we're in the shot. You're supposed to just walk away.
All right, go.
Disgrace. Terrible. Terrible.
Does Jackson know?
Go, senor!
Alright, take number whatever.
Shouting and shooting, I can't let them catch me. I have to make it to Rose's back door.